So what kind of changes would you recommend to improve the holistic and overall care given to improve essentially the numbers of COVID as well?
Well, I mean, the most basic challenge is to keep the numbers low.
Yeah.
Right. So if the numbers are kept low, then there will be no surge that will drive hospital occupancy. So our hope is that the vaccination drive that we are beginning in earnest next month, which hopefully will attain herd immunity in the NCR plus 8 by Christmas time, will substantially mitigate the risk of another surge. We are not talking about new variants. Yes. When new variant comes in, everything is off the table.
Yes, but I think I was going to say, Father Nicanor, is herd immunity for the year looks like it's off the table, and it's even the government that admits that. That's why they're targeting what they call population protection. Yeah.
So clearly, we will not be able to attain herd immunity for the entire country. There simply are not enough vaccines to go around at this time because there's a severe global shortage. So the government has opted to focus its vaccination strategy on the NCR plus 8. That's about 38 million Filipinos out of the 112 million Filipinos. And my colleagues and I in OCTA are in support of the strategy to try to achieve herd immunity in the limited number of urban locations that are being targeted at this time, because these are the hotbeds for COVID-19. Mm-hmm. So if we are able to control the pandemic in the NCR, then other provinces, other islands will not be as, they won't be at more of a risk, because we are feeding, you know, our viruses are feeding the surges that you're seeing elsewhere in the country. There are mayors in the Philippines who have observed that about 2 months after a surge in the NCR, they get surges in their LGUs. And that's what you're seeing now. You know, you're seeing in the Visayas, you're seeing in Mindanao, you are seeing surges because Filipinos who were in lockdown in the NCR have now been released. They go home to the province and they bring the virus with them, and now it's driving a surge. So the hope is that by inoculating the capital, inoculating the metropolitan areas, we can indirectly but securely protect the rest of the country.
Okay. Should there be a re-strategy in the use of the vaccines or the allotment of the vaccines?
So at the moment, so the government has announced recently this NCR plus 8 strategy, which is much more focused and is more attainable in terms of herd immunity or containment of COVID-19 by the end of the year. And so I and my colleagues at OCTA are supportive of that. The question now is, so the government has announced that 70% of the national vaccine supply is currently being allocated to the NCR plus 8. And so the question is, will they increase that allocation to accelerate the vaccination in the NCR plus 8? That is both a scientific and political question.
Okay. And what do you think then? You've said it yourself. It's a scientific and political question. Go for the scientific one.
So the science, of course, would emphasize if we are going to do the NCR plus 8, let us allocate as much of the vaccine supply to the NCR plus 8. We have always said from the beginning that we have to leave 10%, because regardless of prioritizing whatever region in the Philippines, we need to vaccinate all our senior citizens. So all our senior citizens around the country have to be protected, whether they are in the NCR plus 8 or outside. Mm-hmm. So we leave 10% of the vaccine for them.
For our seniors.
For seniors and medical frontliners. But if we can, you know, 90% of the rest of supply would bring forward the date by about a month when we have all the vaccines that we will need to vaccinate the NCR plus 8. But again, this is a deeply political question.
Okay. Last night, Secretary Galvez had said that vaccination with seniors is quite low. So he said it's very difficult to convince the seniors to get themselves vaccinated. And Secretary Roque just now said there's the A1 to A3, including the seniors, have been given enough time already to be vaccinated, and it's time to open it to the A4 and 5. Should there be new strategies to engage the seniors for vaccination? I've asked that as well. I mean, to ask them to register online, some have said that's too much. To ask them to go to the site itself, some have said they won't go. So there's so many other challenges with seniors other than the mindset and the trust issue itself.
So Okta is working in collaboration with Quezon City. So I'm actually much more intimately aware of the challenges of the vaccination rollout in Quezon City.
For seniors.
And we are facing in Quezon City, there are challenges too associated with our informal settlement. So our poor senior citizens are particularly hesitant. And so we have to reach out to them. And
yes,
I think one of the things that we are going to be talking about in Quezon City is a barangay level outreach with barangay people who you know and trust coming to talk to you about vaccines. So that's one. And the second is to try to mobilize, to develop mobile clinics.
Yes, for vaccination.
So drive the vaccination
to the barangays,
our slums, to our barangays, and then you park it outside the barangay hall, and the senior citizens go to a familiar place. They know the people, they are surrounded by friends. They're one of the things, we have not yet attained herd immunity, and yet the masking requirements have been lifted. And I think that the government has to be ready to gradually relax the minimum health standards as more and more Filipinos are vaccinated, to do two things: to give us hope and to give an incentive to those who are hesitant. So I encourage the government over the next few months to explore possible ways to begin to relax the minimal health standards for those who are fully vaccinated, so that they will show on Facebook and social media that we are going back to normal and that everyone has a role to play in this.
Okay, just quickly, there was a discussion between Senator Cynthia Villar and Senator Nancy Binay on that. Senator Villar said she wants fully vaccinated elderly to be allowed to go out. I think Senator Binay said no, but they can be spreaders. So what do you think then?
So the data, at least
quickly,
the data basically shows that at least the two mRNA vaccines prevent transmission. We are waiting for data from the others. If we show that there's no transmission, we should still allow our seniors to leave who are fully vaccinated. They might still have to wear a mask, but at least they can leave their homes after 15 or 16 months.
Okay, that's quite big. Huh? That's a big recommendation coming from Okta Research Group. Thank you so much. I'll talk to you again. We'll talk about other changes to come that you want the government to do. Thank you so much.
God bless you, Father Nate.
God bless you too.